How's it going? What's going on, everyone? I'm Cameron. My pronouns are he and him, and I'm here on Talking Simulator in order to play Tactical Breach Wizards, which sounds extremely cool. This game sounds kind of like exactly my brand of game. Magic XCOM? That sounds great, honestly. What's not to love? Amazing writing too. Okay, I'm excited. These XCOM likes are very, I kind of made my name on this platform 10 years ago playing XCOM. And I love that game in spite of its many problems because these games go wrong right away, right? The balance in them is very fine. Because nothing feels worse than putting a bunch of resources into rolling a flank. You put an operative into danger, into harm's way, but they've got a very good chance of clearing a room. And then, like you're using all your resources to get them into that position and to maximize their chances of doing it. And then they just miss. Because on one hand, that's life, right? That just happens. That's a thing that can occur. You can do everything right and have things go wrong. What did Captain Picard say about that? Something inspirational and patriarchal, and comforting. But on the other hand, that also sucks. Right? It's no fun when that happens. Yeah, I don't play games to experience life. I play games to avoid life. Right, one can make every move correctly and still lose. But usually at that point, someone wins, right? You can actually say, like, well, I lost this game, but somebody else got to experience victory. But in a video game, is that true? It doesn't feel like it. That's not weakness, that is life. Thank you, Gekyoryu, and thank you, Jaded Cynic. But apparently, like, this has a rewind mechanic because magic. So that's exciting. Just baking in the save scum and making it part of the game's mechanics. Genius move. Love it. Absolutely love it. I also really liked, honestly, Mario versus Rabbids. Rabbids? Dabbits. Terrets? Wabbits. Mario versus not rabbits. I really liked where it was just like Rabbids. That's, yeah, something like that. The 0, 50, or 100% hit chance is a very good balance. You like to listen to smart people. So who's on your main monitor then? Right, Mario versus Rabbids Kingdom Battle. That was it. Iron Danger tried the rewind mechanic, but it didn't like. Yeah, I've heard there were other issues with that game. Yes, Chaos Gate's like also Chaos Gate did a lot of things I liked. It just didn't. Man, I don't know. The higher difficulty levels just being damage sponges was like, this is not fun. Right? I wanted to love Chaos Gate, but it was just like, there were just enough little things off with it that annoyed me, you know? Like getting to that mission where you have to blow up the Plague Marine, the giant Nurgle thing, and it turns out to have like 50 health. I would love an XCOM game actually where the AI is incentivized to preserve their own resources. Right? I feel that Chaos Gate had an opportunity to make a like a game where it's Grey Knights, who there's like 1,000 of them in the galaxy, versus Plague Marines, of whom there can't be that many left, right? Where the AI is incentivized to protect its own dudes. I cannot see the Death Guard throwing their lives away. They're kind of all about not doing that, right? I don't feel Nurgle worshippers go into battle being like, yes, my life, I will sacrifice myself for this cause. Yeah, they still recruit, right? But like, they're... I feel if you worship Nurgle, you do so with the intention of kind of like wanting to live forever. Right? That's the vibe I always got off Typhus. Right? No, we're too tough to die. So the AI in these games that seems to want to inflict damage on you, no matter the cost to themselves, is, it doesn't feel right. My Easter egg in your RPG project is out in the open. Amazing. I mean, my opinion on Nurgle. Sorry, we're getting way away from things. But I still love the way a friend of mine, Leah, described Nurgle as being the god of saying skipping therapy is self-care, actually. I think that's a lovely, like, description of Nurgle worshippers, right? Why are you going to therapy? Do you think it's because you're better than me? Is it because you want to get better? You're already perfect. You don't need to go to therapy. You don't need to take your meds. I love you just the way you are. Don't ever change. Right? Like, I feel that would be like an interesting interpretation of that god. Anyway, what do you feel about like kicking some dudes out of windows? How does that sound? I think that sounds quite fun. Oh. Yeah, sure. Have all my information. Okay. Options. Let's see how bad the screen shake is. Corvus, I did not. Are they good? Let's see what the default difficulty like is, or what the default difficulty feels like. But I really feel that these games kind of live or die on the basis of how their hardest difficulty feels. Tom Francis is the goat. Ooh, okay, okay. This is technically the third entry in the Defenestration trilogy. Amazing. Left click selects, right click issues orders, middle click deselects. Okay. Shall we just get into it then? Let's go with the default. I love the, what do we call these kinds of beards? The spec op beard. that tactical guys wear. Interpreted as a wizard's beard. And also with the, in Canada, we call them boonie caps. But, you know, the tactical wizard hat. The tactical, like, tactical guy hat. Softwood silence, MAC-10s. MAC-10, you guys. So are we kind of like a high-speed, low-drag operator? Breach glyph. Bolt burst ability. I guess they know what they want. Navy Seer? Boo. Did the enemy not go? Oh, I guess we had an ambush turn. Then there's probably an initiative mechanic. Oh, because we were in cover. Okay. Could they not move, though? Is it a running gag that everyone is in a, everyone goes out a window? Okay. Use the foresee button. Hmm, that's no good. How do we get that to not happen then? Unpleasant. But if there was a way to save them both. Well, I can't unkill the hostage. But I can rescue can rescue Liv, or Liv can break out. Okay, interesting. Navy seer is an actual term. I could. Okay. Hey. Good. So I need to hit them in such a way that this guy goes out a window, this guy goes out a window, and this guy gets smashed into the wall. How many actions do I have? Okay, that didn't work. What are we doing here? Oh, I get it. Okay. Why can I not chain bolt? I'm in the way. Gotcha. Oh, I wanted to, like, go back and access the laptop, though. Oh, wait, I still can. Okay. So we want to what? We want to use Zan. To draw him out. Okay. Oh, okay, there we go. Right, it moves him in front of the window. Okay, there, got it. Sorry, I was just learning the, you know, the language of the game. It's the tutorial. This is kind of charming. No windows. Okay, he's gonna come around here, right? Do we know that, though? Ow. Sorry, just working out exactly how I want this all to go down. Oh, okay. I get it. Or... What I would like to do is blast him into a desk. Where's the laptop? Seal all reinforcement doors. Okay. That was way more turns than necessary. Okay. I think... Oh, well, that was... No. You back. Oh, you can restart the encounter to practice predictive bolt. Okay. Okay. Thank you. This is cute. I enjoy this. Okay. Okay, we can defenestrate 3 with chain bolt. If we get to here, 2, we can only get 2. This guy and this guy and this guy. But we can take cover from everyone else, I think. Okay, I think I like breaching here. Okay, this is fun. Oh, reinforcements blocked 0. Well, it's fine. It's fine. Gaming. Does this graphic style have a name? I realize I'm familiar with this graphic style. I enjoy it, but I don't know if it has a name or not. Cell shaded? Yeah. Yeah, I remember, wasn't this heavily derided around the time of Wind Waker? Legend of Zelda. Interesting turn of phrase. Ooh, XP. Oh no! We didn't level up Van. Zan. Van Zesker. Ooh, plus one target. I do kind of like hitting at point blank range, though. Just be gone. Outfits. Hell yeah. Cool. Ooh, I like his mother's record player. Speaking of records. Hey chat, it's you. I can see you from here. It arrived in the mail today. Well, FedEx today. I realized that since this is a black square to you, this is Marcus Fjellström's The Last Sunrise of the Year, his posthumous final album and unofficial, not really, soundtrack to AMC's 2018 series, The Terror. It is a four-suite album consisting of Last Morning Watch, Last Drafts, Last Best Efforts, Last Fixed Position, and Last Heat, Last Exertions. So, if you were a fan of The Terror, you have every right to be jealous of me. Okay. Ars Technica makes a totally functional starter record player. You don't want to get one of the little, like, briefcase ones. Those ones are terrible and will damage your records. But, like, spending, like, $300 on an Ars Technica turntable? Totally good. Totally good. Or Audio Technica. Sorry, Ars Technica is a different thing. Audio Technica. Right. I don't know why I confuse those things in my head. Possibly because they share many of the same letters in a similar order. Confidence is only needed to start wearing more daring. I love this structure. I love this. If you pull off bigger and more impressive bullshit, you can wear cooler outfits. How do I get rid of this guy? Oh, we have a grenade. We have one action, huh? Oh, but the grenade is only single use. Okay. So we use the grenade to knock these two out of windows. Just book. I love these strings. This is a very MechWarrior 2 kind of soundtrack. MechWarrior 2, the clans, had the best gaming soundtrack ever, and I will fight you over this. So we could chain bolt these two. No, that didn't work. Oh, it only does one damage. What if we move here? Nope. Brain. I want to hit him back into the wall. I'm aware of how chain bolt works. I just wish I could knock them both backwards instead of sideways, you know? Because it will chain from one into the other. So this guy will get knocked back, but this guy, since it chains from him, will get knocked over here. You can bounce chain bolt off allies too. I can only chain it to two things though. Yeah, I think I may have screwed up with my, with my advancement. If I had taken three targets on chain. So chain bolt isn't going to work here because it only knocks one person out, so I might as well just use static blast. Okay, here's what we do. Oh, Jen can still move? I think she's used up all of her move. Gotcha. No, this isn't quite right. Okay, here's what we do. No, that doesn't work either. Laptop. There is not always a laptop. Okay. Mm-hmm. Gale Grenade knocks these two over here. We can three round burst. If we move here, we can shoot this guy. This guy is going to be a problem. Because this guy can just fire a grenade around a corner. Zane got a new ability too. Time boost. One extra action. Okay. And we each have one mana. Brain, we can do this. These are the only two who are within grenade range of each other. Okay. So we move Jen here. She grenades these two into walls. Zan blasts this guy? No, that doesn't work. Grenade is only knocked back one. And there's no windows to knock anyone through. We need to take out the grenadiers, right? Let a single teammate perform two actions in one turn. Deal with all enemies by the turn end of turn one. Jesus. Okay. The blue boxes can be picked up for mana. I like this a lot. I like the confidence goals. Get rid of all these people in one turn. What are Zan's abilities that cost mana? Just time boost. But these generate mana. So we could chain bolt here, hit this guy. They both get knocked back, this into this wall, this into this wall. Then how do we get rid of these two? We have two actions. So that's actually two chain bolts. From here to here, would that work? And the guy in the corner is in cover. Okay, let's try it. Nope. Nope. Okay, he's in cover there. So how do we chain bolt everything? Actually, hold on. It's time for me to take a break. I'm gonna take a quick break, and we're gonna, like, think about this one. And when we come back, we'll see if we can do it. I mean, I might have needed to take the 3-point chain bolt, which is a bit of a bummer. That's a bit of a bummer. But we'll get over it. Anyway, I'll be back in like 5 minutes. All right? See you soon, chat. I return. How are we gonna do this? For the record, this is awesome. I love this. I'm gonna have to pick up all of these games. This feels like the first time someone has... Well, it's probably not the first time. This feels like the correct understanding that these games are puzzle games. These are puzzle games. It's like how, well, I mean, like, okay, when I say that, I also mean, like, I always say genre is a glove or a lens that we can use to either manipulate or examine a game rather than, like, a hard and fast thing that a game must fit into. It is a interpretive tool, right? But, like, when a developer uses that tool to create an experience, it can be very powerful. And this feels like the developer has decided, no, I want this game to be a puzzle game. And that feels great. That feels like the experience that I've wanted from these games. It's like if Miyazaki one day said, like, we will now be developing all our Dark Souls games as if they are rhythm games. And I would be like, I'm in. We are in. I was already in, but now I'm 1000% in, right? If every fight is now gonna feel like Dancer of the Boreal Valley, baby, yeah. Also, there was a leftover Krispy Kreme donut in the fridge, and I microwaved it for 15 seconds. And let me tell you, those carbon oxygen bonds and carbon hydrogen bonds and carbon carbon bonds in sugary fatty icing love being microwaved. Ooh, microwaves pick those things up and jiggle them real hard. So this thing is like magma. But yeah, the microwave will walk up to icing and just give it a solid, like, wham! Right square amidships. Probably didn't even need 15 seconds. Could have used... Okay, so Zan is going to give Jen an extra action. And she is going to wander in here. Blast this guy? and then grenade these two. How does this work? I don't know all of her ranges yet. No, this is not going to work. We need to knock these two somewhere. I wish I knew if these guys were going to move. They are not. Right? Does knocking remove cover? I mean, I feel like it should, right? We should want to grenade people who are in cover. Okay, if it's not indicated, they won't move. Good answer. Thank you. Who can even see each other from where they are? Can you two see each other? Oh, this guy lived. How did this guy live? Right, because this doesn't actually do damage. So we need to not be here. We need to move, like, here. There. Okay, that's it. stupid. Stupid, stupid, stupid. Should have time boosted. I cannot time boost. Well, I guess that's what we're doing then. That doesn't feel great. Not the cleanest, not the cleanest. But I feel worth one bite of stale donut. Oh ho. Interesting. Okay. Okay, we're gonna do this slightly differently. Is this guy going to... Okay. How are we going to do this? Will Zan's predictive bolt trigger on an enemy being knocked back? I think it might. I think that's what that goal means. Oh, that's bad. Okay. I didn't even see that person there. Okay, interesting. Figuring these things out is incredibly satisfying, chat. I'm really vibing with this. I think we've done everything we can reasonably do. So we've got to get Zan to knock this guy out so that Jen can take out, well, these two. We've already moved, so we won't be able to move if we breach. But if we do breach, I think we can shoot this guy? That doesn't really help, though. I'm not going to be able to do Zan's confidence goal. That's a bit of a bummer. Or... yeah, if only I'd been able to, like, set up a predictive bolt for it. But I think that felt okay. Turn one was the setup for Zan? Okay. We got one of Zan's goals. Uh-oh. boss fight? Not good enough. I would rather not get hit by this. We need to find a way to knock him two squares. I guess we could move out of the way. That would probably help. Is this... sends forth a spectral motorcade of ghost riders that hits everyone in... okay. Well, not great, but... seems okay. Not ideal. Can't use it on myself, huh? Womp womp. Oh man, I didn't even see the other one there. Be gone! Oh, I wanted to defenestrate him. Boo! I didn't even read it. I should have read the confidence goals. Yeah, knocking him into traffic would have been amazing.
Who?
I like a free attack. The writing's fun. It's very kind of like quippy, I guess, but it hasn't annoyed me yet. You know? I think it runs the danger of running into kind of like a Joss Whedon-esque, like, quippiness. But it hasn't yet. I think I like it so far. What do we think? Supportive fire seems really good, but it does depend on being able to, for both people to see it. Two knockbacks though. Two knockbacks feels very strong. Confidence 3. Gotta respect an old lady with a pipe. You see an old lady with a pipe, you know you are in for some either no bullshit or intense bullshit. But there is no dissuading an old lady with a pipe. I like the nickname Duck for an operator. I think that's kind of funny. Hey, Corey, things are going well. I'm enjoying this game a lot. I wonder what the A-minus patch stands for. Two watches, presumably so you know when it's time to Tokyo Drift Race. Blood type? I guess A negative? Sure, why not? Yeah. Oh, is duck a term for someone in the Navy? Yeah, because Zen has, this portrait is a Marine portrait, right? This is a Marine in general? Or a Marine uniform, not a Royal Navy uniform, right? With the big white broad-brimmed hat and then the black tunic. It's a very north of England slang term, like mate. Oh, okay. Mate's more broad, duck is more affectionate. Man, I'd hate to be referred to as having a flimsy soul. Yeah, he was a Navy SEER. It just looked more to me like an American Marine uniform. I guess though, Marines have the flag in the background. Like it's not, right? It's not supposed to be, but this evokes US Marine for me a lot more than it does Navy. Oh, we didn't get starred completions for the last two missions. 95 minutes late. Oi. Kitty. He's gonna let us ride with a shipment of bathroom supplies and pornography. I want to know more about the cat. Interesting development. Can't see through this, I think. All of these tabs are great. Oh, if I had done their confidence tasks, or if I had done all of their confidence tasks in the previous mission, I would have been able to unlock either Desert Detachment or Jungle Tracker. What do we think? I kind of prefer the blue accessories on Desert Detachment. And you know, I'm a big fan of black. Dark Heart's very strong. I like how in his dream he was wearing the Urban Arcanist outfit. Perhaps we simply don't buy that for him and it doesn't happen. 2 reinforcements total. Is that through here? I wish we were just a little bit faster. Can you do corner to corner? No bueno. It's turn 3. Shit. We need to be more aggressive. I wish we could just get more moves, you know? Can we restart the level? How are we supposed to get? Oh, there's a different way in. There's a different way in, okay. Or not? There is not. Those are windows, sadly. Okay, so how do we get from there to there? They have too much armor. I think I see it. Damn, I was hoping to be able to knock it. I wish I could knock it this way so that we could get a predictive bolt on it. How do we do this? We need to be able to grab the intel. We can do this. I believe in us. We can do this. Okay, that's... How do we get the intel and then... I think we have to do it this way. Okay, I think I've got it. Sorry, this is me being extremely stupid. Nope. Dang. Okay, we can do this. We can do that. We almost had it. We just did one wrong move there. But it's fine. It's fine. It's fine. It's fine. It's fine. We're fine. Everything's fine. Doesn't do anything to it. So might as well just take cover and enter. No, we can't seal the door and hit the turret at the same time. They need to be next to each other. They need to be next to each other in order to do both. Can she knock it back with her own grenade? Good question. But we can knock it to the side with the grenade so that it's here. Can you hear the... I'm just getting static through my headphones. Weird. Okay. I think it was the headphone jack. I muted everything because I thought you were getting blasted by it. Only one use per encounter, huh? That only took 45 minutes of roughly stochastic efforts. Okay, that's fine. That's fine. That's totally fine. We're gonna look so good at the end of this. That's a large dude. Lays down so much fire that you'll take a little damage even in cover, heavy enough to resist one knockback. I think I see a path forward. One knockback resisted, huh? I was hoping to knock him that away. Okay. Two knockback off chain bolt. Can I knock them back? That wasn't bad, but it wasn't ideal. If we can use the Gale Grenade to knock this back, that might work. turn three, huh? Turn three. Three enemies left. This blows. I can still do it if I can blow away this guy, right? Then this will fire on him. If I had mana, I could... No, I can't even chain it that way. Okay. Okay, 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 okay. I liked how that worked before. Which, if I remember correctly, we... Okay, good, 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 good. Perfect. Looks great. Thank you. Wait, when did we get poisoned? Where's the turret control? All the way over there, huh? Yeah, odd marks on themselves. Oh, right. Okay, yeah, we take cover. Can we not take cover here? Oh, right, because we had predictive bolt. I'm so smart. How do we false prophet this thing? Nope. Ah, we gale grenade it. Naturally. Be gone! doing this all wrong. I'm doing this all wrong. Okay, I still like Gale Grenading this guy. That seems correct. We False Prophet? Or... Dang. Okay, no, sorry. Okay, 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 we're fine, we're fine, we're fine, we're fine, we're fine. That's different. How was I blowing up the thing before? Because right now, just static blasts. Or, sorry. I was directly in line with it? Like I was over here? Okay, they stun them for a turn. I don't like this. I shouldn't have used the time boost unless I had something to use it on. Okay, we're good. We're good. We can figure this out. I like this, actually. Okay, that seems good. That is much less good. I need to knock him over here, or into here, or using predictive bolts. Nope. Why did you run over here? Why did you run all the way over here? That sucks. That sucks. No, that doesn't do anything either. Okay. That really felt like me just, like, clicking on everything in random orders until it worked, but... Alakablam! Excuse me. Us both. Yes, right, we were poisoned. So when did we get poisoned? Did I just miss that? Refresh your move after firing. Yes, please. What did it say about, how did we get poisoned? What did it say? It was mentioned in one of the briefings? Oh, okay, it tells you later. Oh wow, it's 4:30. I need to wrap up the stream. Thank you all so much for being here. I really enjoyed this. I love this as a, this is so much more rewarding as a puzzle. I think this interprets XCOM as a puzzle game, which is much more rewarding than XCOM, which is a probability-based tactics game, if that makes any sense. Like, things just work. The enemy behavior? I love how the enemy behavior isn't deterministic. They move to different places. You have to, like, even if you rewind, the enemies might decide that what you're doing requires a different behavior. It's so good. I love it. This feels like the result of 15 years of iteration into the XCOM formula. I love this. I'm so happy with it. The writing is fun too. It's a little, it's towing the line on being cutesy, but it hasn't annoyed me yet. So I think maybe the writer seems to know what he's doing, which is a lovely thing. Okay, I'm gonna wrap it up here. Thank you all so much for being here with me. And I will see you in the future.